Hiya, Martin here, and thank you for joining me for this week's Turning Project video. I hope you're all well. This week on the lathe, I have a monstrous piece of sycamore, and I genuinely have absolutely no idea what I'm going to do with it. It was a little bit bigger than the lathe, so I've had to shave a little bit off it using the outrigger, but I'll cover the outrigger in a different video. It is a monstrous piece. It's 16 by 4 and a bit inches, and I really don't have a clue. So I've got some tear out on here on the end grain, and there as well. Yes, I tear out on the end grain, and it's partly because I'm having to turn this quite slow at the moment. So I'm going to get the glasses on, slow the lathe down to 100 RPM, give it a little spin just to get it started. And it's on 130mm faceplate. And I'm just going to slowly bring up the revs. Yeah, that's 300 RPM. I don't want to go any quicker than that. And the tailstock is here for support. Freshly sharpened half inch bowl gouge. And I just need to start or finish getting it round. That's about as round as I want it. Still got plenty of tear out on this end, and there looks like there's a branch coming in here, or some kind of knot. That I think that will pretty much turn out. So let's start to face off the piece. I'm going to leave the tailstock in for as long as possible. Right, so there's the recess formed. And I don't want to have a big sort of wide open expanse of nothing in the recess. So I've created this little feature, and I'm doing that very slowly with a round nose scraper. Which I'll go back to after I've sanded it and add a little bit of texture. There's a little bit of tear out, but that should sand out. It's tearing out because there's just not enough speed, I don't think, to get a decent cut. I still don't know what shape I'm going to do for this, but it needs to have a pretty big foot. So start on the big corner over here. 455 will do to start with. Okay. Right, I'm at a shape I'd like. There's still a little bit of tear out. I got rid of most of it with the scraper, but there's some lovely figure in it just there, which is causing the tool to bounce, which isn't ideal. But you know, it's wood. What else can you do? So now I'm going to hit it with the sander. I'm going to use the drill today purely for speed, and then I'll come back to you when I've decided what I'm going to do with the outside of the piece. Okay, I've sanded the outside down to 400 grit, and it's come up really nicely. I'm very pleased. And now I want to add the texture to the bottom, like I said I was going to. So I've got the texturing tool, and it's roughly on centre, as you can see. And I'm going to turn it over. I think that's got to be about 45 degrees. Give the piece a spin before starting the lathe. There's centre, and put it in and count to five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hope you can see that okay. That's quite nice. It's too far over, so I'll turn it upright a little bit and do another one. Two, three, four, five. That looks better. And then move on to the bigger tool and do another one. Right, let's try this. I hope you can see that okay. And now I'm going to pull the tool rest in, grab the Les Thorn skew. I want to mark out some lines. I want a thin line in there, a thin line in there, a thin line in there, and a really thin line out there. That's going to look really nice. I'm very pleased with that. Very pleased. Right, I need to change a camera angle and then show you what we're going to do next. I decided over lunch that I wanted to put a belt on here, a belt of texture, and then colour it. So I'm going to take the large tool again. I'm going to have to get the tool rest as far out as it'll go. And I think, bearing in mind I haven't faced off the top, so I need to leave a little bit of a gap at the top. And put another mark there. So in between those two lines is where I would like the texture to be, roughly. I'm not going to be too picky about it, but that's roughly where I want it to be. And because I've got this hard bit here, I think it might be a little bit tricky, but we'll see. So I've got the lathe going. It's up to 440. Gonna lie the tool over. And somewhere in between the two lines, I'm just gonna put the tool into the wood. Let's have a look at how that looks. Ooh, okay. That's quite an interesting texture. I think you can see that. Okay, now I'm going to border that with the little tool at the same angle as the other one. These tools always sound really funny, and it sounds like they're doing a horrible job, but that's actually turned out okay. Now I can move the tool rest in closer, and then I can put a line in between each of them and also over the top of the pencil marks. Next, what I want to do is put masking tape either side of the two outside lines. Let's just make sure there's no dust on it. Right, what I want to do with this is just have a bit of a black feather inwards from each side, and then have a rosewood kind of centre. So I'll get the lathe spinning. And that's all there is to it, really, I think. I hope. Yeah. It's subtle, but that's definitely a brown and a black. Cool. Right. Put that down carefully and take the masking tape off. A lot of overspill, but I think for the most part it'll be okay. So I just need to sand all this back, sand that block back, and then continue. So the sanding didn't quite work. It was just getting a little bit too hairy. So what I've done instead is I've actually made a little scoop out on either side of the coloured texture, and that works much better. So now I said I wanted to put a brown feather across the bottom, running up the sides. So I've got the airbrush again, and I need to run the lathe fairly quick. And then just very lightly start in the centre and move the brush out, and I want to kind of finish up about here with the faintest part of the feather. And to make the feather, I'm pulling away from the piece so there's a wider spray pattern. There. That's nice, I'm happy with that. And now I need to leave that little lot to dry off. I've put the sanding sealer on it. Let it dry, cut it back, and I've just added a single coat of Hampshire Sheen High Gloss just to purely satisfy my curiosity as to whether or not that's the finish that I want, which, feeling how nice it feels, yes it is. I haven't put the gold gilt on the belt yet because I want to do that at the very end. So, here we go. Okay, after a mammoth amount of sanding, I have finished it down to 400 on the inside, applied some cellulose sanding sealer, and then finished it off with Hampshire Sheen High Gloss. I'm talking quickly because the batteries and the cameras are running out. And next, the last thing I want to do is just add some of the gilt onto the belt that we put on. And I'm going to use Compiègne, the Liberon gilt cream called Compiègne. It's French. So I'm going to get a little bit on the towel, spin the lathe up to about just over 600. Now there is a little bit of a wobble on it, so I don't think it's going to go on evenly. And then I'm just going to touch the paper onto the wood. I don't want it to be a solid colour all the way around. I want it a bit messy. Well, not messy, but you know, a bit patchy. And I think let's put it in reverse and then do the same on the other side. The other way around, I mean, not the other side. And there, we're finished. And here is the finished bowl. As you can see on the inside there, I'm not overly happy with the transition from the wall to the base, but it is still a very nice piece. And then there's the back, and then just round the rim there you can see all of the gold gilt. Well, thank you very much indeed for watching. I hope you enjoyed this week's project video. I'm going to have something different next week, but for now, if you have any comments, please